I'm gonna pull a couple of these saws so we can talk about them. These are the only two saws that I use to frame a house. And I use each one just a little bit different. So I'm gonna talk about that. Then I'm gonna talk a little bit about some of DeWalt's recommended best practices on how to take care of these batteries so you can get the most life out of them. This isn't gonna be a Ford versus Chevy type of conversation. I'm not gonna tell you how much yellow that I bleed for DeWalt tools. The main reason that we use the DeWalt brand is because that's the type of battery that we've acquired the most of over time. So when we buy new tools, it just makes sense that we stay within the DeWalt brand. I'll give you links to both of these saws in my description and the batteries that I'm going to talk about. And if you want to see me using these in the field, I'll link to some videos below. So this is their 6.5-inch cordless saw. It takes a 6.5-inch blade. This is my go-to, use all the time, everyday, general purpose framing saw. It's pretty light. It's balanced really nice. I can sight the lines real easy when I'm cutting. Once I got muscle memory established, it's really easy to find the safety every single time. This is a great little saw. Now, their 7.25-inch worm drive style saw. There's only two times when I use this thing. And one of them is when I'm rolling floors. I need the extra depth out of that 7.25 blade so I can cut through an I-joist in one pass. If you want to see me go into town with this saw on some floor joists, check my video links below. The other time I use this is on the roof. The only reason I use it on the roof is because of that right there, the sky hook. I need to be able to hang this thing wherever I want so I can have my hands free to do other things while I'm working up there. So the sky hook is super convenient for that reason. If this saw had a sky hook, I still think that I would use this saw when I'm working on the roof. Most of the cuts I'm making up there are from the top down, like when I'm cutting tails for fascia. So the extra weight of this saw lets the gravity pull it through the cuts. So I get some really nice cuts and it's really effortless when I'm working up there. Now, about the batteries. This is a 60 volt max, 20 volt, 9 amp hour battery. The battery that I got in the back of this saw, it's also 60 volt max. It's also 20 volt, but it's only a 6 amp hour battery. The only difference between these two batteries is that this has 9 amp hours and this has 6. This battery has a little bit more runtime. This isn't going to be a technical video about how these batteries work. If you want to geek out on some good videos, there's tons of information available about these things. All I want you to know is that the more amp hours that you're able to afford, the longer you're going to get these batteries to run. Think of it kind of like a fuel tank. The 9 amp hour battery has a bigger fuel tank, so it holds a bigger charge, so it's going to go for a little longer. These things are kind of expensive, and so I want to try to do anything that I can to prolong the life of them so I can get them to last a little bit longer. This is what DeWalt recommends as some of the best practices on how to manage these batteries. The first thing that they say is when we're working in extreme conditions, like it's really cold or it's really warm outside, and we bring these batteries into room temperature, they recommend that this thing acclimates to room temperature for a couple hours before we actually put it into the charger. Now, I'm probably not going to do that because that's just not the reality of how we use these things on the job site. We're constantly bringing batteries in and out of here, putting them in the charger and swapping batteries out all the time. To sit and wait for 2 hours before I put this into the charger, it's just not realistic for me. The second thing that they recommend, and this is more of a note than a recommendation, is that it's impossible to overcharge one of these batteries in their charger. I used to worry a lot about charging these things at night and then going home, thinking that I was going to keep them in the charger too long and it was going to deplete the life of the battery faster. They say that these chargers go into a maintenance mode once this battery has reached full capacity, and it'll hold the battery at full capacity until the user is ready to take it out, put it in the tool, and now the battery is ready to go to work. The third thing they recommend, and probably the number one thing that I can do on the job site every single day to prolong the life of these batteries, is by not letting them discharge all the way before I recharge them. What they recommend is that as soon as you notice a loss of power in this tool, it's time to recharge the battery. So if the blade's spinning really slow, or it's acting like this, and it's taken 5 or 10 seconds to make the cut, this thing should have been in the charger a long time ago.